సార్ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ సార్
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ మేడం చెప్పండి
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ సార్
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ ప్లీజ్ టెల్ మీ హలో గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ ఐఎమ్ ఆడబుల్ హలో ఐఎమ్ ఆడబుల్ ఆర్ నాట్
ఎస్ సార్ యు ఆర్ ఆడియబుల్
ఓకే సో సంబడి మేడం టెల్ మీ వాట్ ఇస్ యువర్ డౌట్ then work it. So okay, today we will discuss about the monopolistic competition market. Okay, so we know that based on the competition, the markets are divided into two categories. That is a perfect competition market. It's a perfect competition market and a imperfect competition market. So in the part of this imperfect competition market, we have four categories. That is, one is monopoly, what we discussed in the last class, and monopolistic competition market, what we are going to discuss now, and we are also have the duopoly and oligopoly. Like that, there are four type of the imperfect competition markets are there. Okay, in this class we are going to discuss about the monopolistic competition market, okay, which is called a monopolistic competition market, what you can say. Okay, here in the monopolistic competition means there is a competition. Please remember here, there is a competition here. There is a competition like among the sellers. There is a competition among the sellers. See, here in this model, that is a monopolistic competition. In this particular model, the model of the monopolistic competition describes a common market structure in which the firms have many competitors, but each one sells a slightly different product. So yeah, the main important feature of this monopolistic competition market means in the perfect competition market, there are many sellers are there, no doubt, but all the sellers are selling the same product, homogeneous product selling by all the sellers is the main important features of the perfect competition market. But whereas in the monopoly market, only one seller will be there, is selling the same commodity without having any substitution commodities. But in this particular case, in this monopolistic competition market, there are many sellers are there, but all the sellers, they are selling slightly some differential commodities. Because there is a product differentiation is one of the most important characters of the monopolistic competition market. Because the same commodity with the substitution, with the alternative, with the differentiation commodities, selling by the many sellers, we can see in this world. So this is the market we can see in the real life. Perfect competition market may not be exist in the real life. Monopoly also may not be existed in the real life. But in the many aspect, we can see that the monopolistic competition market is existed in the market in the for the many cases we see. So this monopolistic competition is a form of competition that characterizes a number of industries that are familiar to consumers in their day-to-day lives. So as I said now, day-to-day life, we can see this type of the industries. Okay, this type of the markets we can see in the real life, day-to-day life. So example, restaurants. For example, restaurants. There are many restaurants. There are many restaurants producing same product with some differences. Okay, there are many hotels. The restaurant A, the restaurant B, the restaurant C. All the restaurants are producing the biryani. But the biryani from the hotel A is different from the biryani from the hotel B and from the hotel C. Like that, these days, there are all many types of the textile industries. But in case of the textile industries, so some Raymond may be different from the Philippe, may be different from some other brand. So like that, what we can say. So like restaurants, air saloons also many. But the air saloon of this particular person may be have the different with some other air saloon. Okay, like clothing and the consumer electronics like we have fan. The same fan may be with the different brands, Bajaj, like Usha fan, some other brands like that. Okay, like AC. Okay, we have our like watch, camera. Okay, like mobiles. We have different type of the brands like that. So all these commodities, we can say, example for the what is called the monopolistic competition market, because they are producing, many people are producing the same commodity with some differentiation. Okay, with some differentiation, what we can say. So in this perfect competition market, we can see some important features like this. Okay, then like a large number of firms will be seen. Large number of sellers we can see in the perfect competition market. So the way the clothes related to goods and will be there and no homogeneous as said already. Okay, in the what is the difference between perfect competition market and monopolistic competition market? In both cases, we can see there are large number of sellers. But the difference is in the perfect competition market, they are selling the homogeneous product. But in the imperfect competition market, they are selling with the close substitutions. But the differential commodities are related commodities are selling by the many sellers, what we can say. And there will be product differentiation, we can see. All the commodities, I already told you, they are not homogeneous. They have little bit of variation. So that is called product variation is one of the most important feature in the monopolistic competition market. And there will be free entry and free exit like perfect competition market. okay, many companies can come and the existing companies may exist from the industry also. And overselling cost and over expenditure on advertisement is one of the most important. Selling cost. So here, the same commodity with some differentiation. So that's what to attract the customers, to attract the consumers, almost all the companies, all the sellers, they are giving the advertisements. Okay, they are giving the advertisement and attracting the customers and the consumers, we can say. And a lack of perfect knowledge. Okay, the knowledge may not be available to all the consumers and all the sellers also. Okay, lack of perfect knowledge is one of the things here. And a pricing decision. Okay, and each and every seller, they have their own pricing decision. But now, completely, whenever they are taking the decision, definitely they will look after about the others also. For example, here, the restaurant A and the restaurant B is there. The restaurant A producing biryani, the B also producing the biryani. These two people, they can have the independent right to decide the price. But automatically, see, for example, so the A biryani is 300 rupees and B is only 200 rupees. Definitely, this impact will be there on the B on E, yeah, also. So that's why even though they have the independent decision regarding the pricing decision, so it will, since it will be influence the others. So it is indirectly depending on others. So almost, so if the price will be near to that another that company. So that is the near, not may not be exactly. I'm not saying that you have homogeneous price, the same price for all the commodities. The price also differs because individually they can have the power to decide it in case of this one. So these are the some important features you can see in case of the monopolistic competition market. Like, so as I said here, the pricing power. So as in a monopoly, firms in the monopolistic competition are the price setters or the makers rather than the price taker. If it is the perfect competition market, so it is the price taker only firm. But yet, like a monopoly, price maker rather than the price taker. Okay, it may take one decision regarding the price. And however, their normal ability to set price is effectively offset by the fact that demand for their product is heavily price elastic. Okay, so this commodity price definitely will depending on others and demand, whether it is an elasticity or not. If there is an elasticity for their product, there is a more elasticity of the demand for their product. So slightly they will try to decrease the price and so they will try to sell more product in the market and they will get more profit. For example, there is a inelasticity of the demand for their commodity. So then the producers will try to increase the price and maybe sell little some product in the market and will sell in the market. So like that, we can see, so this particular thing. And in order to actually raise their prices, the firms must be able to differentiate their products from their competitors by increasing their quality, real and perceived. So always they will go for the competition. So they will try to increase their quality and they will compete with other companies in case of the price, quality and everything. So because of that, they will maintain some quality regarding for this one. Okay, so this monopolistic competition. Okay, so in the long run, please remember, always, whenever we are talking about this monopolistic competition market, so in case of the, what is called monopolistic competition, okay, competition market. So what we can say, in short run, the firm definitely will get the abnormal profit. Generally, the firm will get the abnormal profits. Abnormal profits will be getting. And if it is abnormal profit, so sometimes it will be with the normal profits also it will get the equilibrium. Sometimes it will occur the loss also. Okay, loss also. We know the loss means? Loss means AC is more than AR. Already we know. Average cost, if average cost of the company is more than the average revenue, so then we can say that the company is incurring the losses. Okay, if AC equal to AR, average cost of the production is equal to average revenue of the production, if that is the case, the company is getting the normal profits, what you can say. Okay, normal profits getting. At the same time, if AR is more than AC, average revenue is more than the average cost, so then it will, we can say that so it is going to get the abnormal profit. Okay, abnormal profit. So in the short run, the firm may get the equilibrium with abnormal profit or normal profit and loss also. But whereas in the long run, always the firm will get the equilibrium with normal profits only. Means where average cost is equal to average revenue. Average cost is equal to, so average revenue, we can say that. So like this, in the perfect competition market, in the imperfect competition market, particularly in the monopolistic competition market, so we can see this one. Okay, see, if it is the what is called long run, so as I said already, the firm is going to get the what is called normal profits. So yeah, since it is a monopolistic competition market, it is in the part of the imperfect competition market, always the average revenue and marginal revenue will be downward slope. So this is the average revenue curve. Okay, this is the marginal revenue curve. This is the average revenue curve. So as we know already in the last class, in the imperfect competition market, marginal revenue curve and average revenue curve, they will be downward slope. And marginal revenue curve always below than the average revenue curve. Okay, this we already we know that. So what is the condition to get the equilibrium? Where MC is equal to MR, there the company is going to get the equilibrium. The condition to get the equilibrium of any company is MC should be equal to MR. That is, the marginal cost should be equal to marginal revenue. So here, this is the marginal cost curve. This is the marginal revenue curve. At the point A, the both MC is equal to MR became equal. And MC, that is the marginal cost curve, touches the MR curve from the below. Okay, marginal cost curve touches the MR curve from the below. So that's why where the company got the equilibrium. The firm got the equilibrium. The company got the equilibrium. So at this point, this is the price. This is the price curve. Average revenue curve, nothing but price curve. Okay, this is the price curve, you can say. This is the price curve. Okay, this is the average cost curve. Where AC is equal to AR. Why? Because in the long run, I told you, the firm will get the normal profit only. Normal profit, nothing but the condition is AC should be equal to AR. Okay, if this is the AR, this is the AC, average cost. So this is the price, So this is the average cost. So the price is equal to average cost. The price is equal to average revenue. So that's why since AC equal to AR, we can say that the firm got the equilibrium with the normal profit. Okay, yes, see, please remember, whenever we are talking about this one, actually, after the getting the equilibrium also, the average cost is decreasing. The average cost is still it is decreasing. This is known as the excess capacity. Even though there is a capacity to produce more commodities with low cost.
Combine.
Hello, please mute yourself. Okay, this is the excess capacity. Okay, excess capacity, nothing but after the getting the equilibrium of the company also, the average cost is decreasing if the number of the production will increase. Number of the production will increase. So even though if the firm expanding, the average cost is decreasing the gradually, but the firm is not trying to the expanding. It is not trying the expanding. Without expanding, the firm is getting the equilibrium here itself. Okay, this is known as the excess capacity. Okay, the excess capacity, product differentiation, selling cost. These three are very, very important aspect in monopolistic competition market. If it is short run, this is the condition. Okay, you know that if it is a short run, we can get loss or normal profit or abnormal profit also. Abnormal profit, nothing but AR is equal to AR is more than AC. See, for example, this is the marginal revenue curve. This is the average revenue curve. The MC got equilibrium with the MR here itself. That's why the firm got the equilibrium here. So at this point, the price is this much. Okay, this is the price of the commodity. Price of the commodity, because this is the price curve, you know. Okay, this is the price, but this is the average cost. So this is the cost. Okay, this is the average revenue, this is the average cost. Since AR is more than AC, we can say that the company is getting the abnormal profit. Company in the equilibrium with abnormal profit. So otherwise, take for example, okay, this is the MR curve. Okay, this is the AR curve. Suppose this is the marginal cost curve, where MR is equal to MC, there the company got the equilibrium here. At this point, this is the price. Okay, this is the price. Price is equal to average revenue. But this is the average cost, for example. This is the average cost. So this is the average revenue. But this is the average cost. Okay, this is the average cost, this is the average rate. So yeah, this much is the loss for the company. Okay, yeah, why? Because the average cost is more than average revenue. So the company got the equilibrium with the loss. Company got the equilibrium with the loss. So if the company is getting the loss, this will be the diagram. If the company is getting the abnormal profit, this will be the diagram. If the company is getting the normal profit, this is the diagram. Okay, in the long run, always it will be get the equilibrium with the normal profit only. But in the short run, maybe abnormal profit. Okay, this is what is called okay, abnormal profit. Okay, abnormal profits are, so whereas this one is a loss, when the company is in the loss, this will be the diagram. Okay, like that in the shorter period or long period, the monopolistic competition market is going to get the equilibrium like this. So here, again, please remember, in the monopolistic competition market, there are three very, very important points. There will be product differentiation is one of the most important point. Selling cost, that is advertisement cost. Selling cost means advertisement cost, other than the production cost. Other than the production cost, after the production of the commodity, to increase their sales, to boost their sales, to attract the customers, the companies may spend a lot of money on the advertisement, okay, which is called selling cost. Okay, that selling cost is one of the most important feature in this particular company. And the third point is excess capacity. Excess capacity, even though average cost is decreasing, the firm is not expanding their production. So that means the resources are wasting. There is an excess capacity. The complete capacity is not utilizing in the monopolistic competition market. So these three are very, very important. What is? One is a product variation. Okay, differentiation. Product variation or product differentiation. Okay, the second one is, okay, the second one is like selling cost. Selling cost. And the third one is, so like excess capacity. So these are the three important aspects we can see in the monopolistic competition market. Okay, yeah. So see, the selling cost, nothing but they are the expenses on the advertisement, the salesmanship, free sampling, free service, door-to-door canvassing, and so on. All this, whatever the amount spending on these items, so they will come under the selling cost. Under this market, where the product is differentiated, selling costs are essential to push up their sales. Since the product is differentiated, selling cost is very, very important. It is very essential to push up to increase their sales. And they are incurred to persuade a buyer to purchase one product in the preference to another. So to attract the customer instead of another commodity, the customers have to purchase my commodity. To sell my commodity to the customers, I will try to attract the customers. To attract the customers, I will try to give the advertisement. Okay, Chamberlain. E.H. Chamberlain is one of the most important regarding this one. So E.H. Chamberlain is the most important person regarding the monopolistic competition market. According to E.H. Chamberlain, was defined them, that is, them means your selling cost. So as a cost incurred in order to alter the position or shape of the demand curve for your product. Generally, to increase the demand for their product, whatever the amount spending by the seller will come under the selling cost. So that is Professor Chamberlain himself find a way out by the confining selling cost to only advertisement expenses. So selling cost is nothing but advertisement expenses. That is what Chamberlain told about that monopolistic competition market. Okay, so the monopolistic competition market, that is about the what is called monopolistic competition market. So in the imperfect competition market, after this monopolistic competition, the next one is a duopoly. Please, yeah, duo, nothing but two, poly, nothing but sellers. Duopoly, nothing but there will be two sellers. There will be two sellers, we can see. So duopoly is a market structure in which only two sellers or producers we can see in the market. Only two producers or two sellers we can see in the market. This is the basic form of the oligopoly competition. Oligopoly means few sellers are there. Among the few, two also few. So the duopoly is the part of the oligopoly actually. That's why some of the economists are saying that duopoly is not a separate market, it is the part of the oligopoly. But since it was there as a separate market in our syllabus, we are going to be discussed. So duopoly, this is the basic form of the oligopoly competition. So the two players sell multiple buyers and sellers competing goods or services. Only two players. Two players, nothing but two sellers will be there. Your players, nothing but sellers or producers. These two sellers or two players or two producers are serving the goods and services. Serving nothing but supplying. Supplying goods and services to the many people. Means there are many customers. There are many buyers automatically. So the two sellers are serve the multiple buyers. That is many buyers and sell competing goods and services in the market. In this market, players have a high strategic dependence. High strategic dependence. There are two people. Two sellers are there. So definitely, by knowingly or without knowingly, whatever the decision, for example, A and B are there. A and B are the sellers. So in the market, definitely the seller A decision is completely effect on the what is called seller B. Seller B decision definitely will affect on the seller A. That's why knowingly or without knowingly, these two people have the interdependence. May knowingly or without knowing also. Okay, their decision are interdependence. Their decisions are interdependence, especially in the making business. Decisions such as pricing and production. How much price should be there? Suppose I am selling some commodity. The same product is selling by some other commodity, some other person. So definitely I will think that when I am deciding my price for my product, I have to think that what is the price of that another person. So when I want to decide the production, how much quantity of the production has to produce, definitely, I will think that how much he is selling, producing. How much he is producing based on his dependent. His decision, my dependency will be there. My decisions will be there. But I will not be direct to that person. Without meeting or without meeting directly or indirectly. So we have some what decision making, what we can say here. Okay, like, yeah. In the duopoly market, we have some important features like, as I told you, market consists of two producers. In the duopoly, we have two producers, we can see. And the producers have a high strategic dependence. Dependence will be there. And the chances of the collusive behavior are high. So sometimes, since only two people are there, there is a chance for the collusive also. Okay, there is a chance for the cartel also. Okay, there is a chance for the contract between this person and that person also. But not illegal, indirectly. Okay, orally they may have. And the level of the competition may be higher. There will be more competition between these two. And the monopoly power is significant. Monopoly power is significant, even though they are okay. Since there are only two people, they will take the independent decisions. Independent decisions, that's why monopoly power is significant. And entry barriers are very high. Except these two, nobody will be there. There are more restrictions to enter in the market. And economies of the scales are high. Economies of scale, nothing but a technological input-output relation. will be very high. So they will try to produce more production with low level of the cost, with low level of the factors of the production. So they will try to produce so the more thing. So in this particular case, particularly there are different models are there in case of the duopoly, like Cournot model, okay, like a Bertrand model, Cournot model, Bertrand model, like that, the different type of the models were there in the case of the duopoly. So in our syllabus, this Cournot model was included in our syllabus. Cournot model. So here, this model is developed by Antoine Cournot. So he was a French mathematician and a philosopher. Antoine Cournot is a French mathematician and a philosopher. Since Antoine Cournot developed this model, so this is called Cournot model. On his name, it was developed as a model, Cournot model. So under this Cournot model, this means Cournot model, the quantity of the determines market competition and thus the output of the competition. Okay, so here, what is the competition there in the market? The same competition there for the production also. Okay, whatever the competition is there in the market for the selling, for the same competition will be there for the production also. Based on that competition only, so there will be production in the company, what we can say. Okay, both firms will be produced at a rate that maximize profits and selects output simultaneously. Okay, they are both companies will try to get the maximum product and output and profit by selling their output simultaneously. Both companies. And each company produces according to the output of the competitors and the market supply. See, by knowingly or knowingly, suppose, take for example, there is a demand for 100 commodities in the market. Okay, there is a demand for 100 commodities in the market. By knowingly or without knowingly, I feel that another person is producing half of the demand. I am assuming that the company B is producing 50% of the demand. So that's why remaining 50% I will produce. So that means out of this 100 commodities, 50% will produce by the company A and 50% will produce by company B. That is what we can see in this particular case. So like that, each company produces according to the output of the competitors and the market supply. And both assumes that the competitor's output does not change. So I will assume that, so you will not change the production, that's why I will not change. He also assumes that the producer A will not change the production, that's why he will not change. Like that, the both people, they will think that the other people are not changing the output or production. Okay, the model also assumes that players do not collude. Okay, the players are not going to be colluding. This is the one of the assumption. But there is a chance for the collude also. And when the market reaches equilibrium, each firm has no incentive to change the output or prices. After we've taken one decision, one, we reach the equilibrium point level, you don't have any opinion changing to change the production and prices. So that is already fixed. So the change will not make any company better. No company is going to be change the prices. And therefore, in the long run, output and prices are stable. In the short run, maybe something it will be fluctuation, but in the long run, always it will be stable. It will be strict. The outcome of the Cournot competition will be between the perfect competition and the monopolistic competition, the equilibrium. Okay, it is like in between monopolistic competition and what is called perfect competition market. So like that, the whenever they are taking the price, whenever they are taking the output decision, so it is like acting between a perfect competition market and what is called a monopoly market. Okay, this is about the what is called a duopoly market and what is called a monopolistic competition market. So in this category, in these two markets, so please, if you have any doubt, please ask me.
Sir,
tell me.
Can you explain one more time the long run equilibrium under monopoly?
I'm not getting your point. Please tell me.
Sir, long run equilibrium under monopoly.
Under monopolistic competition market.
Yes, sir.
So, any market. It may be monopolistic competition or monopoly or duopoly, oligopoly, perfect competition market, whatever may be. First of all, you have to know some conditions that if you want to know the equilibrium, the MC should equal to MR. Marginal cost curve should be equal to MR. That is marginal revenue. That too, marginal curve should be touched from the MR curve from the below. Okay, this is the condition to know the equilibrium of any firm. Any firm, it may be monopolistic or monopoly or monopolistic or perfect competition market, any market. That is the one point. And second, another equilibrium point, whether the firm is getting the abnormal or normal profit or loss. That is we have to know. So yeah, to know that one. If AC is equal to AR, we can say that the normal profit of the company. Company is getting the normal profit when AC is equal to AR. When AC is more than AR, we can say that the company is getting the loss. And AC is less than AR, nothing but AR is more than AC. So then our company is getting the abnormal profit. Okay, abnormal profit. So these are the conditions. This is the condition to know the equilibrium of the firm. This is the condition whether that firm is getting abnormal loss or normal profit. Okay, in this situation, in the monopolistic competition, market, in the long run, always that firm will get the equilibrium with the normal profit only. Okay, this is the assumption. In the monopolistic competition market, in the long run, the firm will get the equilibrium with the normal profit only. Okay, normal profit is nothing but there, AC should be equal to AR. That is average cost equal to average revenue. Okay, if that is the case, in the imperfect competition market, always the MR curve and AR curve, they are the downward slope from the left to right. The MR curve is below than the AR curve. This is the situation about the AR curve and MR curve. And we know that always MC curve and AC curve always in the U shape. Okay, see, for example, this is the MC curve. So this is the MC curve called the equilibrium with MR here. Okay, the firm called the equilibrium with OQ. Why our condition is? Where the MC is equal to MR, there the firm will get the equilibrium. MC should be equal to MR and MC should touch the MR curve from the below. So this is the MC curve. That's the MR from the below. That's why the farmer, seller, the market got the equilibrium with the OK output. So with that equilibrium, whether the farm is getting the ego loss or abnormal profit or normal profit, that we have to know. So we are talking about the long run. In the long run, always the monopolistic competition market will get only normal profit only. Okay, to know the normal profit means AC should be equal to AR. AR nothing but price. So if we draw this line up to AR curve, because this is the AR curve. Okay, this is the AR, this is the price. This is the AR. So OP, this is the OP. OP is equal to price, which is also equal to AR. AR, average limit. Here, what happened now? This is the AC, the average cost, because we know about the MC curve and AC curve. MC curve and AC curve, they are the UCF, and MC curve always touch the AR curve at the minimum point only. So that's why this is the MC curve touch the AS curve with the minimum points only. We have to remember our rules and regulations automatically. Always that is important. Okay, now this is the average cost. Okay, OP, this is the average revenue. And this is the average cost. For example, QR. This is Q, this is R. QR is equal to average cost. Here QR is equal to OP. This is the QRQ. This is the PO. That is OP. So this is equal to this is. So QR is equal to AC. OP is equal to AR. Since AC is equal to AR, we can say that normal profit. Okay, this is how the company is getting the normal profit. So this is how we can explain the diagrammatically about the monopolistic competition market. Okay, are you clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Monica, is the class over?
Yes, over. Over, ma'am.
Okay, then. Okay. So, did you get the YouTube video of the third day, that is on 5th? Are you able to access it?
No, ma'am.
Only the first 2 days we have the video.
Yes.
And the third day we didn't get. But 2 days, yes, again, ma'am. I think I just got it. I will send it on you.
Okay, ma'am, if there, send.
I will send.